So hello all, good morning and good evening. So yesterday we have discussed about what is Node.js, right? So what is Node.js and what is the different modules of Node.js, like core modules, third-party modules, and the custom modules, okay? So now today we'll discuss how to write a program, okay? So how to write a Node.js program and how to execute that and how many ways we can execute. So let's have a look. So let me just for the recap. See, previously JavaScript. So when I talk about JavaScript, it is the front end. And when I talk about Node.js, is the back end. So previously what happened? We used to execute a JavaScript in the browser. So I'll just make a small example. So this is the browser. This is the browser. And along with this, one more environment which is coming from Node.js. That is, this is Node.js. And here, one engine. And this is Node.js. Can you mute once if anybody joined? Yeah. See. So browser and Node.js. So browser is actually one environment which allows us to execute a JavaScript program on the browser. So that's an environment. Same like that, Node.js also one runtime environment or platform which allows us to execute a JavaScript program same way. But what is common between these two is here you will be having V8 engine. This is the Chrome's V8 engine. That's a JavaScript engine which is used in the Chrome. Here also same V8 engine. Okay, so generally how you execute a JavaScript program on the client side. So if you want to execute a JavaScript program on the browser, you must require one HTML, one CSS and one JavaScript file. Okay, so why we need HTML, CSS and JavaScript file is if you want to do some sort of DOM manipulation things, then you need HTML. But I can say you can execute a JavaScript program without need of any HTML and CSS. The plain JavaScript program itself can be executed on the browser directly. Okay, I tell you, in the browser, there is a direct access to connect to this V8 engine to test our code. The example is when I go to the browser, see. Here, how to access this V8 engine directly means the console window of any browser. See, I'm just doing a client-side JavaScript now, and then we'll switch to the Node.js. So in the client-side JavaScript, I open a browser, and I just click on inspect and a console. Okay, so in the console window, this is the direct access to the browser. So what I do is I'll just make console.log some message, welcome to JavaScript. Okay, so when I say console.log of welcome to JavaScript in a browser, see directly you got the output. Okay, and then I'll say another example, I say let a is equal to 10 and then let b is equal to 20. So I have declared two variables, and when I say console dot log of backtick, so the sum of a comma b is a red dollar A plus B, and then backtick, enter. See, you get the answer. The sum of A comma B is. Rahul, please make it mute. Okay, you're disturbing my class. Just mute all. Okay. So now So what happened? When you do console.log, you got the welcome to JavaScript, and also here console.log, you got data. So you are able to execute a JavaScript program directly on the browser. So this is the environment, and this is a place where you execute a JavaScript program directly. Okay, but only one problem with this is this approach can only use for testing purpose. Okay, we can't use for any other purpose. Why I'm saying for testing purpose is when I click on this clear console button, this linker is clear the data, right? So where is my program? So I want to recite my program for much long time, a much lifetime. So for that case, you have to write a JavaScript .js file, and you have to execute it. So that JS file contains permanent content of your data. So this console environment is at the client side to access your V8, I mean the JavaScript engine directly. Same way, we also have V8 engine access to the from Node.js. Means this is one environment, this also one environment. So in the backend, we also have a direct access to the V8 engine through Node.js environment. So what is that is, that is called, so here is called as console window, execute a testing purpose JavaScript. And same way in Node.js, we have REPL environments. Okay, so here we have a REPL environment. So what is this REPL environment is? There is a So what is REPL environment is? You can write something called REPL. So R stands for read. You can read the data, and E stands for eval. You can evaluate data, and P stands for print. You can print the data, and L stands for loop. You can loop data. Okay, so these four kind of operations can be done in this REPL environment. This is the direct access to the V8 engine of Node.js environments. So how to access this REPL? Console window means you can open the browser console and you can just see that. But how to open this REPL environment of Node.js is, see, Node.js is a installable software, right? Same like Java and other programming language. So if it is installable means, so that software, how you can connect is through the command prompt. It means you can execute a JavaScript program through using command prompt as well. Okay, let me open a command prompt. Yeah, this is my Windows command prompt. So in this Windows command prompt, hardly you can execute a Windows commands. Okay, but here I want to switch to REPL environment. So how to switch to REPL environment is, just you have to type node and then press enter. See, so as soon as I type node and enter, it is switched to, see, welcome to Node.js version, and for any help you can do dot help for more information, and it is switched to what? See, it switched from HP to some environment here that's called REPL environments. So here you can execute a same program what we have done over here, because both are having a same engine, because I have opened a Chrome here, this also having a Chrome's V8 engine. So now here I'll say console.log welcome to Node.js. Enter. See, you get the same answer, welcome to Node.js. And what is this undefined is? This is the return type of logger. So log is doesn't have any return type, so it's getting undefined. So you can able to execute a JavaScript program on the console window as well. So because of Node.js environment, REPL. Okay, and you can also create a variables as well. Let a is equal to 10, let b is equal to 20. Okay, so let c is equal to 30. I have taken three variables, and what I'm doing, console, or else I'll do like this, let sum is equal to a plus b plus c. So another variable, sum. So now what I do, so console dot log of backtick the sum is red dollar sum, and then back to close, enter. See, the sum is 60. So 10 plus 20 plus 30 is 60. Like this, you can even print something called console dot log of new date dot to locale some time string. So you get a current time now. Okay. So what are we doing is we are executing a plain JavaScript program on the REPL environment. We can even loop it. So I'm just showing only up to here. Fine. But this is just only for testing purpose. In real time, you must not use this approach because you can't store the data. It means suppose I do control C. So if you do control C two times, so it will come out. And if I say CLS, gone. So where your program has gone. So this is just used for testing purpose. But actual way of doing is you must have to create a JavaScript files to execute a program. Okay. So now let's understand how to create a JavaScript program, the actual way of executing a Node.js program, how. So let me close this. Let me close the browser as well. And I create a workspace. Yeah, and D drive, I'll go to workspace, online classes. So I have already these things. I'll do one thing. Let's make, I create a new folder for this batch. So online Angular 8 batch. Okay. So I have created a separate folder for this batch. So whatever we discuss, Node, Express, MongoDB, Angular, Angular Material, Ionic, everything will be in this place. Okay. So in this folder, I'm going to create, now we are working on a Node.js language. So I need to create a Node.js. So what I do, I'll just create a new folder. You can also create a same like structure. So new folder, I say Node.js. Okay. So this Node.js folder, we are going to write the complete Node.js programs. Okay. So now let me load this Node.js folder to the WebStorm and then start creating the files and start executing the program as well. So now let me open Node.js. And here, let me copy the address. Yeah, so how to load this particular folder to the WebStorm is copy the address and then open a WebStorm. So here, click on file, open, and just paste. Okay, okay. Yes, so see now, only that empty Node.js folder has created. So here we are going to create each topic. We are going to create a separate folder inside. Okay, I create a new folder here. So how to create a folder inside Node.js folder is right click new directory. It means folder. So what I create is some 01 underscore Node.js underscore basics. Let's make some basics. Okay, one folder. So inside, I don't need to create a HTML and CSS because it's not a backend code. I mean, it's not a frontend code, it's a backend code. Okay. So in the backend code, I'll create this one JavaScript file. So you can create right click new. If I say new, you can find HTML, CSS, JavaScript and all this. So I'll just select only JavaScript. So I'll just make here app. Just say app and press enter because automatically it is creating a JavaScript with .js. Just say app and enter. Okay. So now it is created an app.js empty file. So now here I'm going to write any JavaScript, some functionality, and I tell you how to execute this separate JavaScript program. We have seen till now how to execute in the REPL environment, and we also see how to execute the same JavaScript program on the with the Node commands. Okay, so let me write a basic example. Let me write a console log message, or let's make a log message. Yeah. So one thing you have to understand here is As I said, Node.js, but I'm writing JavaScript code only. See, remember, here and here. This is the front end and this is for the back end. So browser is an environment. Node.js is also one environment. But this browser environment is executed, the client side, and this is for server side. So both the environments, one language is common. What is the language? Is JavaScript. So the same language you can use at here as well as here. But one thing which is not there in JavaScript concept of, one JavaScript concept in Node.js is DOM. In browser, you have DOM concept, right? So you have all the programmatical concepts and then DOM manipulation and then advanced JavaScript like ES6 features, scopes, callbacks, promises, asynchronous JavaScript, like collections, classes, and all this. So every concept of JavaScript programming will be available in Node.js as well. But only one concept which is not there is DOM, document object model. It means the document object and the window object functionality. So why DOM is not there means this DOM is specifically designed for browser. So if you want to do something dynamically on the browser, then you need a DOM. But at the back end, we don't need the DOM. Okay, because we don't need we don't have a browser to manipulate the server side, right? So except DOM, every concept of JavaScript is allowed. And except that, we also have a core modules and all other stuff. Okay, so same JavaScript we can use over here. Let me back to here. I'll just make a console log. So console. So the advantage of editor here is, so you get this automated options to write quicker programs. Console.log, I say, welcome to Node.js. Yeah. So I have written console.log of welcome to Node.js. I save it. Fine. So how to execute this particular JavaScript program? So previously REPL environment execute directly, but how to execute a JavaScript program like this? So how to execute this JavaScript program is you have to open a command line. This means the integrated terminal of WebStorm. So when I click on a terminal, see, this is the same like your command prompt, which you're using in the outside command line, command prompt. This is called as terminal integrated with WebStorm. Yeah, here. See, where is my app.js is inside of Node.js basics folder, but where I am in Node.js folder. So I have to switch to Node.js basics folder and then execute this program. So I can write the command, the Windows command cd, change the directory to 01. Just give the tab. Let's press the tab button. So you get Node.js basics. So change the directory to Node.js basics and press enter. So now it is switched to Node.js basics. So now your app.js also there in a same location, right? And then you say node space app tab, node space app.js. Yeah. So how to execute a JavaScript program using Node.js is node space the program, the file name.js. Either you give file name.js or you can just give file name only, because hardly everything is just JS only. So just say node space file name, that also executes. So now check, I have written node space app.js and press enter. So you get welcome to node.js. Yes, I get the message. So this is how you execute a program. If you are not sure, sir, Windows command, sir, I'm not sure the command cd and cd space dot dot means backward. If you are not sure about this, no problem. You have a easy method. See, if you want to execute a JavaScript program app.js, so this is available in this basics folder. So what you do, just select this folder and right click. There is an option called open in terminal. So automatically this particular folder is going to open in the terminal. See, it's directly open a Node.js basics. You can just simply do node space app.js enter. So you get the message. This is also you can do. Okay, fine. So not only just console log, let's make some basic examples. Let's make an object. So I say let student equal to one object. So just say name, Rajan, and age. I'll make some 40, and course, engineering, and then address. I'll just give Hyderabad. Okay, so I have created a student object. I want to print the student object here. So this may write a console dot log of student. Now save it. The student object I have printed. Now let me see what is the output is going to come in my terminal. So let me open a terminal window once again. So here, and one more shortcut is you can type node space app.js, or else if you want to get the previous commands what you have typed in the terminal, just click on the up arrow or down arrow. Up arrow, down arrow. Suppose I have entered some CLS command. CLS means to clear the entire commands what you have entered. Just clear. Okay. So I have entered two commands. One is node, one is CLS. If you want to get the previous commands, instead of typing the complete data, just click on the up arrow and down arrow. See, it's coming. So now I want node app.js, press enter. See, I got welcome to node.js, that's the first console log. And the second console log is my student object got printed. Okay, so let's make a simple array. It is the basics of node.js. Actually node.js is not started. You can start with the modules, but meanwhile, let's recap on JavaScript here. Now here, I just create an array. So let's make something called colors is equal to one array. So inside you can create white and black and blue, and then silver and red. Okay, so I have colors one array. So I want to print the array on the console. There's nothing to do. Just print it. console.log of colors. Now save it. Back to terminal. Enter the previous command. I mean up arrow. Press enter. So you get all the message. One object and one array. So one last thing. I'll just show you how to make a function also. Okay. So I hope you already know this concepts of JavaScript. Yeah, now let's make a simple function. So what is this function is? Basic function, let greet me is equal to one function. I'm writing a function expression. You can even write an arrow function as well, your wish. From ES6 arrow function also you can write. Yep. So here I'll just take a name. Okay. So here what I'm doing, I write simple console.log of. I use backtick from ES6. So hello, Mr. I want to print a name. So just say dollar name, and what do you say? Good morning. Okay, just say hello name and good morning. Fine. So this is one very basic statement from my JavaScript function. So I just call the function. So greet me, I am passing John as a parameter to the function. So greet me of John. So it takes a John and hello, John, good morning. So let me go and execute a program. So good terminal. And a paro press enter, you get the answer. Hello, John. Good morning. Fine. I'll just change this to Wilson. Now save it. Back to terminal. A paro enter. You get the message. Hello, Wilson. Good morning. Fine. So these are the very basic JavaScript. But now let's understand how to make use of the Node.js modules. As I explained in the last class, Node.js is having three set of modules, right? So node is having, okay, let's make a node modules. Node is having a three set of modules. One is core modules, and second one is third party modules. That's also called as NPM modules. And then third one, custom modules. Okay, so now core module means, as I said, OS module, FS module, HTTP module, path module, like many, many other modules are there. So let's have a look how to use these modules and how to start working with them. Okay, so let's have a look how to start with the core modules. And also one more thing, each one module from Node.js is a huge set of JavaScript files and a lot of JavaScript functions. So please don't try to remember each and every function. You have to just follow the documentation of Node.js. So let me open a Node.js official documentation, and through that we're gonna practice on core modules and then continuously for third party modules and the custom modules we'll see. So let me open official documentation of Node.js for reference. So let me go to Google, and I'll just go to Google here, and I type Node.js. So when I type Node.js, so I get the website Node.js.org is the official logo. So let me open this. Yeah. So in this, so how to open a documentation is, let me click on a docs. See, let me click on this docs, and here you have to select the version. So we are using a 12.14 API. So just click on 12.14 API. Fine. So you get the Node.js official documentation. So here, what is the module I'm going to discuss now is OS module, means the operating system module. So this is allows us to get operating system specific data. I mean, to extract the operating system data, and we can use that for any other programming purpose to access the OS data. So for this, let's have a look for OS module in the left side sidebar. See, there is something called OS here. When I click on OS, so this is the complete OS module functions. See, you can find out something called free memory, home directory, host name, the platform, release, template directory, total memory, uptime. So like these many functions are available, and how to load is like this. Yeah, I tell you. So let me start with Node.js core modules. So I will just close this. So basics over, I'll just create a new directory, that is 02 underscore node. Okay, let's make a capital. Node.js underscore core modules. Okay, core modules folder. So in this, I will create a new JavaScript app, enter app.js. Okay, so now here, how to use this core module here? It means, and also always remember, Node.js comes with a long list of modules, right? So by default, Node.js comes with all the list of modules, and these modules by default not available for your program. Suppose I am writing a program here. Sir, is that OS module is by default available for me so that I can call it? No, you must have to import that module to your program. It means you need to inform to the Node.js that yes, I require now OS module. So please give me the OS module so that I can do some functionality with the OS module. Suppose you want to get the FS module, you have to just tell to the Node.js, yes, I require FS module to continue my functionality. So how to say the information to the Node.js, I required OS module, is if you inform that, it will automatically import that OS module to your program. So how to do that is, you can do constant OS is equal to, there's a keyword called require. So require, here you have to say the OS. So this is the statement to import to ask the Node.js to import OS module. So I require now OS module. I save it. But one small issue is here. What is that is, see, this issue only in WebStorm, not in any other browsers. All the editors will work perfectly, but only for WebStorm, you have to do some extra configuration for Node.js. So by default, Node.js code assistance is not available. So you must have to do some extra setup. What is extra setup is, see here, when I hover for the require, it says unresolved function or method required. It doesn't know what is meant by required. So required is a basic keyword to load or to import any module. So it is not recognizing the required keyword, means the Node.js code assistance is not enabled. So first you have to enable the Node.js code assistance, and then it starts recognizing these keywords and this modules as well. See, if I hover, what is saying? Code Node.js coding assistance is disabled. Let me make it enable. Either you do here only, or else I show you the exact place where you can do it. So click on file settings. Yeah, once you click on file settings, yeah, here there is a link called languages and frameworks. Click on this last but one. So when you click on language and frameworks, so you have see Node.js and npm. Just click on this once. Yes, see here, coding assistant for Node.js, it is not checked. When I check this, so it is configuring the coding assistance for Node.js. So I have a different modules of installed already of Node.js. Maybe you may not see these things. It's okay, no problem. Just select this checkbox and then click on OK. So now see, required, and this error has gone. See, okay, let's make one more time. So I say constant OS is equal to required. If I say req, see automatically require is come, and here when I say O, see Node.js core module. So it start recognizing the node concept. See, all the node things has come. Okay, so node has been loaded. I mean, OS has been loaded. So this is to load or import any module. Okay, so once you have done, so the entire OS related functions has been stored to OS. Okay, so now let's start using the OS module. So the very first one I want to execute on one function I want to use, that is total memory. Total memory means the total RAM size what you have in your system. Okay, let's make total memory. So let's make let total memory is equal to OS dot total memory. Okay, and then let me do a console dot log of backtick. So total memory is gonna be total memory. So I'll just save it. So now let me execute the program to find out what is the total memory of my system. So let me click on a terminal. So now we are in basics folder. You can do cd space dot dot to go to the previous folder, and the forward direction cd space 02 tab enter. Now in a core modules folder, if you are not sure about all this, just click on the Node.js core modules folder, because my JavaScript file is in this folder. So you can just select, right click, open in terminal. Yes, it opens automatically here. So close the previous command lines. Yeah, so here what you do, node space app dot js and press enter. See, you get the message total memory some number. So 12 and something has come. It means my RAM size is around, I mean, it's a 12 GB. So let me check this number with my system properties. So I'll go to my computer. So this PC, I right click and go to properties. you can just check installed RAM memory is 12 GB. So that's what it is printed over here, 12 and something in bytes. Okay. And then one more function, there's something called free memory. So how much is free? Okay, so here, so let's free memory os dot free memory and then console dot log of so use backtick, so free memory with the data is just say free memory. So let me go back to terminal again, press the up arrow, enter, see free memory 7 GB, so almost 5 GB is in use. Okay, and then let me understand there's something called, okay, let me just see the functions of Node.js now. Home directory, yeah, let's find out the home directory now. So home directory, so what is meant by home directory is whenever you open a command line, whenever you open the command prompt, automatically some directory will be coming in a the path, like c colon users, and this is your username. So this is exactly called as home directory. We can access this as well from Node.js OS module. So let's home directory, I can write directly now. So let's say directly console.log of backtick. So just say home directory, let's say dollar, so home, sorry, os dot home directory. So now check, instead of creating an individual variable, I'm just calling directly in the console log. So let me go here and run the command. I get home directory, c colon user slash hp. Okay, same path. And then any other home directory, host name, yeah, what is this host name? Let's find out. So let's make a host name. Host name, your system name. So let's make a console.log of host name. So I just do dollar. So os dot host name. Yeah. So I just go to terminal again. Enter. See desktop. 34URS. This is the name. So where to find out this host name or computer name is, go back to your my computer and right click on this, go to properties. So you can check here, see computer name or computer full name is desktop 34URS. So this is what your host name is gonna come over there. Fine. So that's a process. Finish. After this, let's make one last thing. You can even get the user information. There's something called user info. So I'll just do this. So user info, write console dot log of. I'll just type os dot user info. Fine. And let me run the command terminal. Enter. See. User info, you are getting a username as HP. So HP is my username. So actually it's got an object. See, os dot user info function, if you call, the answer is an object. But in the object, I want to access only HP. So what do you do? The object dot username, you can call. Okay, so once you have done that, we run the command. Username is HP. You can even make a proper string. Let me cut this. So backtick, user name, my system username is HP. So let me paste it. So now let me run one more time. So username, so you access total memory, free memory, home directory, host name and username of your system. So this is about OS module of Node.js. And then let's have a look about FS module. So I'm not showing all the functions. You can try one by one function and just see what is the example. And if you want to know, sir, what is this means, just click on this function. Suppose you want to know what is this release, just click on this function. So it give you the complete documentation. See, it returns the operating system as a string. Your complete operating system name as a string format will come in os.release. Okay, so it example and the description, everything is there. So you can just have a try. All these functions, you can have a try. Fine. And now we will discuss another module called FS module. So what is this FS module is called? File system module. It means you can create a file, you can read a file, you can delete a file, and you can create one directory and you can remove a directory. You can rename the directory, rename a file name, like all the file and directory or the folder related operations can be done using the functions of this module. So let me have a look how to create a files and all using FS module. Fine. So what I do, I'll make a constant FS is equal to require FS. It's from core module. Yes. So now for me, FS module also loaded. So let's do some demonstration on the FS module. Okay, so we don't know FS module's functions, so we have to refer the Node.js official documentation for FS module. So let me open a browser. Here, find out file system. Yes, this is the FS module. Let me click on the file system. So it opens the complete file system documentation. See, you can find a lot of functions like directory.close, path, read, read sync, is block, is directory, and see these many. The fs.file exist, create, write, and read, copy the file, and so too many things are there. These many. Yes, fine. I'll just show you some of the functions here. What I want is I want to create or write to a new file. It means, see, in my folder I have only one file called app.js. So my plan is I am going to create one file, something called data.txt. I want to create one simple text file using the file system module, and in that text file I want to write some message. So my plan is I want to create a file called data.txt in my application folder, and then in that file I want to create a text called good morning. So for this is my requirement. So for that you have to look for the FS module, what the function can be done. So it is for create file or write file. Okay, so here you can just check, it is in alphabetical order. You can check, there is something called write to file, WRT. FS dot write file. Yes, this is one. FS dot write file. Okay, just check here. FS dot write file is a function to write to a file. So you have to pass the different parameters. One is file, the file name or the complete path of the file, and the data. So data is, so what is the data you're going to add up to the file? So it can be string format or buffer or typed array or data view, and then some options. You can make some encoding options. Default is UTF-8, and one callback. Okay, so that callback is having an extra parameter called error, and they also given a example. So they explain each and every function, what is a parameter and what type of parameter data, and one simple example. So based on this you can write your logic. So let's have a look how to write the same. So he's writing message.txt and some data. Okay, we also do the same message. So I want to create message.txt and good morning. So how to do is, say I show you fs dot write file. See, automatically the function names is coming, write file. So here you have to provide the file name. So what's my file name? Message dot txt. sh.txt. I enter the file name, and then comma, next parameter is gonna be the data. So what is the data you're gonna add to the file? I'm gonna pass, just say good morning message I want to print it, comma, some options. The default option is UTF-8. This is the encryption that file options, and then comma, one callback, one function. So let's make an arrow function callback, and this is having one parameter. See, callback is having one extra parameter called error. It's like this. So I'll just get error. If any problem happens, if any error happens while doing this thing, so you get the error. So I write first, if any error, just throw the error. That's one thing. And if no error, I write console.log of my some statement, like file is saved. I mean, something called data is saved. Data is saved. Okay. So I have done a program. I mean, a simple function call I have done. Write file. What is the file? What is the data? And what is the options? And then one callback. If any error happens while doing this process, you get the error. If no error, you get the console log. And also please check, we are doing message.txt file creating with good morning message. And before we run the file, please check, there is no file call message.txt over here. Fine. And I want to create it using this program. So let me go to the terminal, cls, to clear the window, and then node space app.js. See, you get the message, data is saved. Now go back to the folder. See, it is create automatically one file message.txt through the program. And when I open this file, you get the message, see, good morning. So now we have done this process successful. Okay, this is about write file, write to a file. Now another example, I want to read the file. I want to read a file content, but I don't need just a good morning, a very simple message. I want to add some good program. I mean, good text. So I'll do one thing. I'll just go here. I'll just copy this, some text. Yeah, this text I want to add to the file. So what you do, instead of good morning, I'll just stay like this. Let's file contents is equal to this string. I have taken a big string, and this particular string is gonna be stored in my file. So what you do, so instead of good morning, I'll just substitute this thing, file content. Okay, fine. And let me check one more time. Close it, or else you can delete this file now. Yeah, delete to refactor, and then let me run again. Yes, I got data is saved. Now go check file created. In that you have a message, the same message you would have given, it is there in the file. Okay, fine. Now looks good. So now what I want is, I want to read the file to read this content. I want to read this file to get this content. How to read file is, you have a function. So what is that is, you have to go back to the documentation, and there is something called fs dot read file. Yes, this one. Let me click on this fs dot read file. Yes, so here you have given some different set of parameters. One is the path, either the path or the file name or the file descriptor, and some options, same, you can give UTF-8 yours, and callback. So callback having two things, one is error and data. So this error means, if any problem facing while reading the data, you get the error, otherwise data. So data means the actual content of a file is gonna be written. So let's have a look. So how to read the file? So fs.readfile. Here you have to pass first property, first parameter is the file name. What's the file name? Message.txt. And you have to give the options. That's my UTF-8. Sorry, UTF-8, comma, one callback. I'll just make a callback like this. But this callback having two parameters. See, you can find here only error and data like this. So I'll just get error and data. So if any error, you can throw the error. If no error, I just do console dot log of data. Okay. So what is this data is? This data actually contains the content of this particular file. So what is the content of message.txt file is this data. So this whole data has been stored data variable. That's what I'm printing here. It means in the console log, I'm going to get this data when I run this program. So save it, go to terminal and run the program. See, you get the data of the file, correct? Okay, so this is how you can create a file and you can read the file. Okay, you can write to the file and you can read from the file, both the things. Okay, now small thing. Everyone, any questions till now? Anybody? Yes. Hello?
No, sir.
No questions? Yeah, fine. We will just move forward now. Okay, so now once we have done up to here, fine. There is one other module called path module. What is this path module is? This is to construct the absolute path of your files. See, I tell you one small thing. We have create write file message.txt, right? So when I say message.txt, where does this message.txt file has created? Message.txt file has created exactly in the main application folder, correct? Exactly here, this folder, fine. But in real time, we won't create a files directly in here. We may create the files inside of some other folder. Suppose I want to create this message.txt inside. I want to create data folder, employee folder. Inside, I want to create message.txt. So you may have to mention the complete path where you want to create and then this one. But here, one small problem is going to come. Because Node.js, so Node.js is a backend platform. Backend means it's going to be the Windows platform or it can be the Linux platform. The server can be Windows or Linux. You may run the program either Windows or Linux. But one problem in Windows and Linux, I mean the difference between Windows platform and Linux or any other platform, the thing is you may not give the path like this. Something in Windows, you're gonna give these type of slashes for I mean to provide the path, and then for Linux or Unix, you are gonna provide the path in this slash, like data slash employee slash message dot txt. So if I write the hard code data, if I write these type of slashes, it may work in Windows. But in future, my Node.js application, if I want to deploy to the Linux environment, Linux server, then these type of slashes cannot be dictated over there. So it must be this type of slash. So here is the issue. So either we give, if we give this one, it only works in Windows, not works in Linux. But if we give this one, it works in Linux, it won't work in Windows. Sir, what to do? To dissolve this, we have a beautiful module called path module. So this path module will construct the exact path as per the OS. Means if it is Windows, it construct the path. I mean, it construct these type of slashes automatically. And if you are running in a Linux, it construct these type of paths automatically. So that's the best thing about the path module. Okay, so let's have a look how the path model is going to create, but I can't show you in the Linux and all. I just show you in a Windows. So path module, again, path module is a core module of Node.js. So it means you must have to load the path module. So before we discuss the path module, we have two global variables in a Node.js. One is dir directory, underscore underscore directory name, and one more global variable underscore underscore file name. So you have two global variables available in Node.js. One is underscore underscore directory name and underscore underscore the file name. So what is this underscore underscore directory name means, which will give you the exact directory name. I mean, up to here, if you're running a, if you are printing underscore underscore directory name in this file, it will give you the complete path up to this folder. And what is the file name is, not only path along with the file name also will come. So let's have a look how to print this data, and then we'll construct the path using these variables. So for these things, nothing to import because these are globally available. So you can just use them directly. So when I write somewhere in the starting, let's see. So before total memory, I'm writing something, underscore underscore directory name. So when I say console.log of backtick directory name, I'll just print underscore underscore directory name. So this is a default and global variable is global variable from Node.js. Okay, so when I say underscore underscore directory name, let's see what is gonna print. Go back to the terminal, enter. Let's check, see, directory name, what has come? So this is actually my directory where I entered node command. So directory name means D workspace online 8 Angular batch Node.js something. So the complete path of your, I mean, your application has come over here. That's called directory name. And one more is there, file name as well. So let me do that as well. So save like this, underscore underscore file name. So let's make a file name, underscore underscore file name. It's also from the node global variable. Let me run the terminal. I mean, let me run the program again. See, now here directory name means only up to directory has come. File name is along with the directory, the file name which you have entered also has come. Okay, so now using these directory names, we can construct the path. So my plan is I'm gonna create a file in data folder, employee folder. And where does this data folder? In your main application folder. In the main application folder, that's my this Node.js core modules folder. In that data folder, and then employee folder, and then message.txt. So up to main app address gonna come with directory name. Only you have to provide data and employee. So I'll just do one thing. I go to my application folder, I create a new folder data. And then inside, I'm gonna create another folder employee. Okay, so here data folder and employee folder. In the employee folder, I want to create something called employee.txt one file. Okay, so how to provide that is, you can construct the path using a path module. So let's have a look path with this variables. So let me import the path. So constant path is equal to require, I say path. So now I get the path module. So using the path module, I'm going to construct the complete path to the up to employee folder. So let me do that now. So if I say here, can I do something here? Okay, I write console. Okay, let's make like this. let's directory path my own variable is equal to, I'm using a path module, path dot join. So this mostly we use this function join, path dot join. So what I have to join is the directory name and then data folder and then employee folder. So you can write join underscore underscore directory name comma what is the next folder you want. Directory name means up to main app will come, and then data folder and then employee folder, and we are not supposed to give the slashes. It will construct automatically depend on a OS. We don't need to give that, only folder names order you have to give. So directory name comma data folder comma employee folder. Okay, so now I'm just telling, hey path, please join up to directory name and data folder and employee folder and give me the complete path so that I can use it to store my data in that particular folder. So now let me do console.log of the directory path is gonna be the directory path. Okay, let's check what happens. Data and employee. So now let me go to the terminal, run the program. See, you got directory path is, see, D workspace something something up to this is main folder, main app folder, inside data folder and employee. And also please check the slashes has built automatically because I'm using Windows environment. So it's come like this. And if you're using Linux environment or Unix, you're gonna get some other slashes. So that will be taken care by the path module. So we don't need to worry about giving this slash or that slash. Okay, so at least now I got a path. So once you get the path, I'm gonna create a file exactly in this path. It means you can give directory path up to here. You can also give the file name as well. You can say employee or else something called data.txt file as well. Okay, let me run the program again. If I run, see, data folder, employee folder, inside data.txt, the complete path has come. So now using fs module, I'm gonna insert some data inside of this folder. So what I do is, let me do one thing. So create a file inside inside employee folder. Okay, inside, let's say data folder slash employee. Okay, let's say, so how to create a file? See, as of now, there is no file inside employee folder. Let's create that. Okay, so what is that is, I say fs module dot write file. And here you have to give the path first, correct? You have to give the path. What is the path previously? Message.txt. Now watch, you have to give the complete this path. Okay, I'll just create a path. Let's some nested path I'll take. How to get the path? So path module dot join. I want to join the directory name and data folder and employee folder and also the file name, that's data dot txt. Then this complete path has come, and this whole path I'm gonna give as a first parameter. That's a path. And then the message, I have already the message, that is file content. Let me do the same copy. Yep, here I'll just do that here, but you must not declare two variables, so I'll just delete the let keyword. So now I get the path and also the content. So next parameter will be file contents, comma the options utf h comma one callback. Okay, so here this callback, you're going to be the error, and if any error while doing this process, you can just simply throw the error to the console. And if no error, I'll just write a console.log of the simple message, data is saved. Okay, I repeat what I am doing here. So creating a file or writing to a file in an asset path where the actual my folder, data folder, employee folder with the file name data.txt and this message. So what I am doing, I am creating a data.txt file in the employee folder with the same data which is already there in the message.txt. Okay, so that's a file content. When file is something, this has to be there in the file. Which file? Data.txt. And which folder? Employee folder of data folder. So let me run the program back to terminal. Yes, data is saved. Go back. See, in employee folder, when I expand, see, you got data.txt and inside you have a file content. Okay, so that's it. And now I want to read the file. So read also, you have to provide the same path. Okay, so read file. Okay, so what you do is, shall we do one thing? Okay, we know how to create a file, right? Yeah. I wanted is, as of now, we are doing only just some normal text content we are printing in a file, right? Shall we do one thing? You know, this current thing, right? This is also file only, no? App.js also one file, right? So which also having some content. So my plan is, I am going to create another file. Name is program.txt. So I want to create a program.txt, same like message.txt. Inside, I don't want to print a simple normal text message. I want to print the whole content of my app.data, because app.js also is a normal file and which contains some text, right? It's a program, but actually it's a program, but when I'm reading like file system, it's one, some data, some text. So this whole data I want to read and create, I want to read this entire data and put it in the program.txt, and that program.txt should be inside a employee folder. So that's my goal. So you have to read this data first and then add to the employee folder. So how to read this data? So let's see. I want to read the app.js file contents and add to or write to program.txt. Program.txt in employee folder. So because you have to know for future other concepts, this is most important. Yeah. So read the app.js file content and write to the program.txt in the employee folder. So first read the app.js. How to read? You can say fs.read file. And here what's my file name? Here you don't need to give the path also. Just give app.js you can give. Or else you can use path module also, path.join underscore underscore directory name, comma, so app.js. See, for app.js, I'm not given any folder because app.js is the direct file of my main app. So main app and app.js, that's a path, comma, read file, right? So I have to give the options. So UTF-8, the default file conversion options, and then callback. So this callback, so while reading, callback is gonna have two things, right? So one is error and other one is data. So this is hold the error and this holds the actual data of this file. Okay, if any error, just throw the error and then this particular data. So when I say a console dot log of data, so let's see what is the data is gonna coming in the console window. Because what I'm reading, app.js, it means the whole application program is gonna printing in my console now. Let me check. Go to terminal. So run the command. So see, you get the complete program. Total memory, loading these things and all, everything. The complete data has come, complete program has come. Even the current program has come here, but I don't need to print in the console. I want to store to a program.txt file. Okay. So what you do is this data holds the content. So now what I do, write So fs dot write file to what file? So in a program.txt, that to inside a employee folder. I just construct the path now. Path dot join underscore underscore directory name comma which folder? Data folder comma employee folder comma file name. So program dot txt. Okay, that's the path now. And the file content. What's the file content? Is my data and the UTF-8 and then one callback. Okay, so this callback is gonna have only one parameter while writing, that's error. So I write here if any error, just throw the error. And finally, let me write a console.log of data not coming. Yeah, let's make some confirmation message. Data is saved. Okay, fine. So now let's control S for save. Let me run the program. And also before running the program, please cross check in the employee folder only one file called data.txt. Now we're going to create program.txt with contents of our program. So go to terminal. So I run the program. Node space app.js, enter. You get the message data is saved. So back to here, see, it creates a folder program.txt. Inside, you have a complete program. Correct? Okay, so this is the beauty of FS module. You can create a file, write a file, you can delete and rename also. You have a huge set of functions. We discuss only the few functions of FS module, but you can just read about for every requirement, it is there. Okay, just have a look. So this is about OS path and FS module. And we are not discussing now the HTTP module because HTTP module is to create a server. So in the next two classes, after two classes, once you finish third party and custom module, we're going to start with a server. Because actually, as of now, I have not started any server. It is just a background processing logic. The server has not started. So we will start a server using the HTTP module after two classes. After we finish third party module and custom module, we're going to start the server. Okay, so that will traps the request and do some process with the request and response. Those concepts we're going to discuss at this class. Okay, so till now, any questions? Let me unmute all. Anybody, any questions?
Sir, whatever programs you run right now, like FS module and path and directory name, file name, everything, do we need to remember everything or just you can find anything?
No, actually. So what is the program I write here? This is the OS module, path module, you have to load in this way only. This you have to remember. Okay, and if you need any information how to do that and all, you can just refer only the official documentation. This is one. So just go to the OS module. If you want to know about OS module, just click on OS. So you can find this function. So these functions not to remember. Okay, so and see, and that require also this person explained constant OS equal to require. This how you can load the module. And after loading the same variable dot, you can call these functions to find out data. And if you want to know what is this function returns, click on the function. It says it returns the string path of the current user home directory. Okay, so based on that, you can write your programs. And same for file system module and any other module. So you have a complete documentation. It's like a notes. See how to load FS module and everything is there. You just need
along
to know,
along with program.
Yes, everything with sample program also will be there.
Thank you.
Any questions? Anybody?
No, sir.
Hi, Mank.
Hi, sir. Good morning.
Good morning. Any question? No. Avinash, Gopinath, Rahul, Sharad. Sharad, no question today?
Yeah, no, sir. Yeah, it's fine. I understand.
Okay, fine. Good. Okay, so enough with this today's class. And tomorrow we are going to discuss about this one. We're going to discuss the custom modules. And then lastly, we'll discuss third-party module. And then we'll start with HTTP, creating servers, creating routers. So all this type of data we're going to discuss.
If you could send the recording.
I'm going to send now. Immediately I'll send. Yeah.
Yes.
So that's it. So thank you so much for joining, and we'll meet tomorrow.